बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। टुडे इंशाल्लाह वी विल ट्राई टू डिस्कस द असाइनमेंट नंबर 4। आई विल इंशाल्लाह टुडे वी विल सॉल्व द असाइनमेंट नंबर 4 देन वी विल प्रोसीड। स्टार्टेड विद द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। यू आर मैनेजर ऑफ अ म्यूजियम स्टोर दैट सेल हिस्टोरिकल रेप्लिकास। You want to forecast sale in term of thousands for the year 2003 using a 3-period moving average method. So it means we want to forecast for the 2003 year. Let's see what are the data given to us. Here we were given the data from until 2002. It means we were given the data from 1998. 99, 2000, 2001, 2002 in term of sale of 4, 6, 5, 3, 5, etc. We need to forecast for 2003. Moreover, the condition is we need to use 3-period moving average method. In the case of 3-period moving average method, means we will forecast based on the last three values. These are the last three values. Then we can make the forecast. It means for if you write a column, the column, then if we write a column, then we for first three value, let me clear it. First three value, okay. Here. For the first three, we do not have any forecast because it is given the 3-period moving values. Regarding this one, regarding say we for 2001, it we started 4 + 6 + 5 is equal to 10 15 upon 3. 15 is the summation, 3 is the total 3 moving average method. Then what about the forecast for 2002? Forecast for 2002 is, this is the forecast for the, yes, it is equal to 6, 5, 11, 3 is equal to divided by 3 equal to 14 upon 3. What about the forecast? For the 2002, last three value will be used. These three value will be used. 6 plus 5, 11. So these three value will be used. Okay, forecast. Now, during the past 8 quarters, Port of Baltimore has unlanded large quantity of grain. Here, they given alpha as the alpha is 0.1. Alpha is equal to, this is alpha, which is given as 0.1. The first quarter forecast was 175. Find the 9 quarter forecast. This is the first quarter forecast, F1. This is given as F1. What we need to do? We need to find the forecast for F9. This is the forecast for F9. We need to compute it. What is required? Let me zoom it, for example, here. This is the, for example, the actual value, and these are the forecasts we need to compute. Okay. Moreover, it is given to, for the first forecast, it is given, it is equal to 175. It is given already, condition is a condition. What about the second, third, etc.? This process will continue until we reached here. Then we use the formula of the Fn plus 1 is equal to, this is the formula, Fn plus 1 or T plus 1, you can say T plus 1 is equal to alpha yt, this is alpha, yt is the observed value. Plus 1 minus alpha, एफ ऑफ टी ओके एफ ऑफ टी हियर अल्फा इज गिवन एज 0.1. इट मीन्स इफ यू नीड टू फॉर द फर्स्ट फोरकास्ट इट इज ऑल एज इट इज मेंशन इट इज इक्वल द फर्स्ट फोरकास्ट 175 इट इज गिवन सो वी आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू कंप्यूट दिस वन वी स्टार्टेड विद एफ ऑफ टू देन अल्फा इज गिवन एज 0.1 एंड वाई टी इज गिवन एज दिस इज द वाई टी 168.1 मल्टीप्लाई वन से प्लस 1 माइनस अल्फा इज इक्वल टू 0.9 एफ ऑफ टी सो एफ ऑफ टी मीन्स दिस इज 175 विच वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्यूटेड ओके वी ऑलरेडी कंप्यूटेड सो दिस प्रोसेस विल कंटिन्यू अंटिल वी रीच सो अंटिल वी रीच हियर ओके So in order to forecast for this one, this value will be used. Okay. Then until we reach them, we can find. Then let's talk about the question number three. Using a trend line, the demand for the electrical power, New York Edison, over the year 1997 to 2000 is given in at the left. The overall find the overall trend. What we were given? For example, we were given the trend from 1997. So in other words, this can represent it, but this is the a data will be given from 1997 to 2003. Here we can write as we want to make the forecast started with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. This is why corresponding Y will be given as. What we need to compute, first we need to compute x and y in order to find, okay, then we need to find x square. This will be used in the formula. Later on we need to find the summation of x. Summation of y. Here we say make a summation of y. Then summation of x phi. Then summation of x square. Then once you find the summation, then we can divide and find the average. How many were number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, divide by 7 or divide by n. Once you find the summation of x, summation of y, then we can find summation of xy, divide by n, summation of x square, divide by, if it required, then summation of x, summation of y, the summation of, then summation of x or average of, in other words, we can say average of x, average of y, this is the average of y. Okay, so first term, then once you find that, then we can apply the formula. So now I am proceeding toward one more thing about, so that it will be clear. Wait for the moment. So then I want to add one more file. Here you can see, for example, here you can see the answer as that, yes, using 3 period moving average method, then it means first three value then what we use if we will start from the fourth value, and we can easily find yes, the moving average for 2001, 2002, okay, then 2003 also. For the 2003, these three last three value will be used. 7 plus 3 10, 10 plus 5 15 divided by 3 is equal to, so it's a forecast for 2003. Regarding this one, as you can see, either you can use the formula as I just showed you in the previous, you can use the formula as f of t, for example, is equal to alpha phi of t. Y is the current values, 1 minus alpha f of t. Or you can use this formula. So it is simplified. So the apply for the first alpha is given as 0.1. The rest of the world, let me show you. Alpha is equal to 0.1. Yt, this is the yt. Then the first forecast is given as forecast given as 175. Then we can easily compute this value in this way. Now, as I just show you, for example, these are the seven values being given to us. These are the data, and as I for 1997 to 2003, what we need to do that moreover, these are the we need to find the x, then find y. How can find the x? Because we are using the forecasting technique using the linear regression. So what? So it may start with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 forecasting. Then this x, this y, this x square. This x y, as I just show you in the then we can easily find the summation of x, summation of y, then summation of x square, summation of x and y. Then the formula is given to us. What is the formula to find? What is the average of x? To find the average of x, just divide by n. Find the average of y, for example, just divide by n. What we found the summation here. Then once you find the average of x, average of y, then we need to find b. What the formula for the b? Summation of x y minus n into average of x, average of y, divided by summation of x square minus minus n of x square. So we already computed summation of x y here, for example, this one. Then it is mentioned here. Then how many of n is there? N is 7. Then average of x, average of y, average of x. These are the average of x, average of y given to us, divide by x square, the summation of x square. Then find the n of x square, and n is equal to find 7. X square is equal to 4. We find solving for this, we find b. It is b equal to. Once you find the b, then we can easily compute a. That a is the average of y. Average of y is given as 98.86 minus b, which already computed as 10.54, then it is equal to 56 point. So we can easily find out the demand of 2004-2005. Moreover, as you can see, this example which was given in the assignment, we have already discussed in the lecture also. So you do, especially for the question number 3, you do not find the problem. Okay, then so now today we will start with this for the simulation, chapter number 5, simulation. First we need to discuss why do we require the simulation. Simulation is as simple as we can say that it is a virtual reality, or using the computer, if some data will be given to us, applying the algorithm, then we can find how the system will behave, what the output of the system. It means how can we analyze any system? The system can be analyzed either we will do the experiment on the real environment, get the result, make the analysis. On the other hand, if make use of the computer in which we are some data will be given, applying some of the algorithm, then some time mathematical computation technique will be applied, and we retrieve the result. दिस इज नो वॉट वी नॉर्मली कॉल द वर्चुअल रियलिटी. वर्चुअली वी आर डूइंग एक्सपेरिमेंट. मोर ओवर इफ यू डिजाइन द सिस्टम और सिमुलेशन विथ सम स्टैंडर्ड प्रोसीजर, द रिजल्ट वॉट वी रिट्रीव फ्रॉम द सिमुलेशन दे आर द रेप्लिका ऑफ द रियल सिस्टम. सो लेट स्टार्टेड, लेट सी वॉट इज हाउ इट इज वर्क. What is simulation? It's a virtual reality. As in other words, as I just mentioned about that it can be defined number as a simulation develop a model to numerically evaluate system over the period of time. It means a definition given. It is something model. Modeling will be done. What does it mean by model? Model means as compared to the real system, we formulate, not a formulate, we define some system parameters, objects, then make a model for them to numerically evaluate. Our purpose is we want to numerically make the analysis of the system, of the real system. How we'll make with the model, with the modeling will be there over the some period of time. Or over the some time period. Obviously, this will be performed for some time period. More, let me, yes. What then, as I just give the definition, another definition for the simulation is it is a virtual reality that will be modeled to describe how the system will behave, what is the output of the system. So, what is the purpose of the model? It attempts to duplicate a system, make the replica of the system. Or abstract of the system. Now it is attempt to make the duplication how the system will be like. And what we need to study, we need to study what is the feature of the system, how the system will behave. It is a reason that will be required for the that reason that so that we can go for the simulation. One more thing about obviously simulation is doing the experiment with the computer. More might be possible. There are some. It depends on the scenarios. Sometimes the simulation technique are appropriate. Sometimes this simulation technique may not be appropriate. Sometimes this simulation technique is something we can somehow more or less something compulsory. I will give the example. For example, during the war. For example, during the war, our previous, in order to have the war, our soldiers, army need to be well prepared. As we can see. Maybe for a country, they may not have war for 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, 50 years. They don't have any war, but they must be well prepared. So how it is possible? Just we can make use of the simulation technique, and using this technique, we can check their performance. Number we will discuss later on. A lot of advantages. This simulation can also be used for the education. Simulation can also be used for the entertainment. This simulation can also be used for the training. This simulation for also be used for the learning purpose. A lot of advantage we will discuss. Then we have another type of the simulation modeling. We have another type of modeling known as analytical modeling. Then first we need to define what is the analytical modeling. What is the analytical model? Then how it will make the difference for the simulation model. Then we can define which one we need to be preferred. In the analytical modeling, results give a general description of a system for any value of the parameter. In other words, we can say for the simulation, what we retrieve the result, they are some generalized in the generalized form. Whereas for the simulation, something they may be specific. For example, might be possible we do the experiment, we make a model, and this model will work fine for some initial condition or some specific condition or some particular interval of time, the system will work very fine. Whereas for the rest of the time, the system may not be so perfect. So that's why we go for the analytical model. Let's see what is different. Then not all the underlying assumptions set for the analytical modeling are valid. Then we will go for the simulation. In other words, we can say when we are doing the experiment, make a model, started the working, and have started the working, and might be possible what because we are meeting the because we made the modeling 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 means we are making some assumption so that it will be simplified. We can start our work, start our doing the experiment. So then some of these assumption they are not valid. They are not valid. These are the condition. They are not these for these conditions the results they are not good. Then we will go for the simulation. Then another possibility then we will go for simulation are when mathematical complexity means it is hard to provide the usual result. Obviously when you make a model and always then sometimes this model is very complex, especially for the complex system, the model is very complex. And complex mathematics will be required. Higher level mathematics will be required. And obviously, our intention is not maybe our intention is not for go for the if it is so complex, then to get the perfect result or analytical result, then they will go some easier way, or in other words, we can say for the for this complex system, complex mathematical will be required, and right now it is not required or so much, then we will go for the simulation. Third one is about the when good solution, not necessarily are satisfactory. Sometimes you are not required to go for the best solution, but require just the satisfaction. Then we will go for the simulation. I will give simple example so that you will understand for the rest of your life. As suppose I want to get the driving license, what I require, it is the condition that I need to go to the maroon office, give the test for the driving. It doesn't matter if I have a driver for the Ferrari driver, or I have participated for the we can say world top racing, but they if my it means either then we can say we then a good solution then it just satisfy the requirement of the maroon get the license. It is not required that they will test me for the Ferrari driver or I can drive in the Ferrari long race or the fast race. No, so that's another we can say sometimes the good solution is required. It is not the always the best solution will be required. I just give the example, fulfill the requirement of the maroon office, get the license. This is the intention that they will not check how so perfect I am. So yes. Now let's talk about the what are the different simulation types for there. There are two type of the simulation were there: discrete simulation and the continuous simulation. What is the, for example, what the first I will explain what a discrete simulation system for there. Let's see for description. System monitor changes in the state of a system at discrete point means a system monitor the changes in the state of some. A system will change its state, okay, and moreover, these changes will only be occur. These changes will only be occur to the discrete point. For example, I want to design a system for the queue system, design a queuing system for the airport, in which the passenger obviously 24 by 7 the passenger they are coming arrival for the departure etc. I want to make a system for the queue for them. Some queue system will be required because this queue system will be this will be required as for the case we can say that I want to go the departure. But first I will go to the boarding office officer for the board, get the boarding card boarding then get the boarding give my luggage go to the immigration. Once I go to the immigration then go to the physical checking etc. All of these steps required what they required the queue. And this is example for the discrete case in which the system the state will be changes only at the discrete point. For example, we can count right now there are 15 passenger. One passenger has completed their work, 14 passenger. Maybe two, three passenger they leave the queue. Then how many of them we can count them easily? We can these are the discrete point. These are the discrete point at which we can check the system state. Second point is about So Q system is an example for the discrete simulation system. Another one is a continuous simulation system, in which system monitor the system is each time it changes in the changes in the state equation. So in here they will not monitor the particular discrete point. Here they mention about the discrete point. Here they will not go for the discrete point. Whenever they are changing, they will monitor them. Whenever they are changing, they will monitor them. I have a simple example. Suppose I want to design a system to maintain the temperature of the computer information system, to maintain the temperature. Obviously, I need to maintain this temperature will continuously be changing. People, they are coming inside the building, people, they are going outside the building. Moreover, some windows, some doors of the building, they are open. So this process is continuously changing. So it means a continuous simulation. If you want to design the system, and I need to check what are the requirement. How can I maintain the temperature of our college building? Obviously, what I required is a continuous process. It's a continuous process. People, they are coming out and the temperature outside, the temperature also be changing. It must be changed according to, must reflected in the inside building. So these are the example for the continuous simulation. Another example for the continuous simulation is, suppose we have the heating system at our geyser at our home, in which we have heated water we got in our tap. So this process again, the continuous process, continuously check sensor, continuously checking what is the temperature of the water right now, because there is a continuous flow or the regulated flow of the water or with the tap. So these are the example for the continuous simulation. Now let's talk of some sample of application for the simulation. Although I will add the comments, add right now with the advancement of the technology, advance of the computer, moreover we have the hundred of the mathematical tool, mathematical statistical tools, they are available, different programming language they are available, different platforms they are available. So it means right now we can easily simulate any system. It means we want to design a system. Obviously, first we need, before the physical implementation of the system, we can check about the what is the performance of the system. Then it can easily be done by the simulation. Computer is with us, different programming language they with us. Moreover, different models, they already available in the internet. We can use the model, change some of the parameter, we can get the result at see, we can see the performance. So in other words, we can say more or less, right, we can say we can apply the simulation system, we can apply the, or we can make use of the simulation system, or right now their application is increasing day by day. Example of the ambulance location dispatching kingdom, they create or develop areas. They develop areas. For example, even you can say the Riyadh city, they are developing some of the outside areas of the Riyadh, they are continuously developing. While developing the system, developing the areas, what they required? They required some structure, ambulances, some ambulance location, police station location, Maru office location. Then they may require fire brigade in the case of fire location. Must have the mechanism for the water, a supply of the water line. So yes, it is possible for the simulation, we can easily learn. Assembly line balancing. This is line balancing. Example, balance the load on the assembly line. We can do that for the parking lot and the harbor design. Parking, let's simple example for the harbor of the Dammam port or harbor at the Jeddah port. They are obviously the continuously ships, boats, they are continuously arriving at the harbor or leaving the harbor. Obviously, they are taking some goods for the port and export, for example. Obviously, we have the limited number of berths in the harbor. So that we can say, for example, at a single time, maybe we can say 5, 6, 7, 8 ships can be dock with the harbor. So it required a simulation. It required a simulation. We will do the example also. Then distribution design. In the distribution design, okay, again we with the making of the simulation, we can easily define the how the system, how it will be distributed equally. Then scheduling aircraft. Take simple example in the airport, in which King Khalid International Airport, we found how many gates there are available. For example, we have the 15 gates there are available. Then it means at one time 15 airplanes can be docked with the gate. Some scheduling mechanism will be required. So some scheduling mechanism will be required. Then yes, we can easily do with the simulation. Then we go labor hiring decision. Suppose for any job we require some labor work will be required, or labor will be required. Then how much labor will be required? For it depend on the obviously required, what are the resources they are available, and moreover what is the demand need to be fulfill the requirement. So we can use simulation. Yes. Then about the person scheduling, even for example we have the, even we schedule the in our classes, it required schedule for the class, for the lecture it required some more or less directly under the submission will be required. Number of students who will register for the course, number of sessions that are required, number of the rooms they are available, etc. Then traffic lighting signal. Have you ever wondered, find out when sometime in the morning we can, in the morning the traffic signal, in the traffic signaling, the timing to are quite different. Maybe in the morning we can say the counter is set for the 60 second, when maybe during the office hour they have the 120 seconds. So these timing they are set with the simulation based on the number of traffic vehicle. Then voting pattern prediction. In the voting pattern, for example, how, for example, currently we found the election in the United States, and people they would make a prediction. Yes, how they make use of the simulation. Then bus scheduling. Bus scheduling means, for example, they need to make the schedule for the bus that based on the required number of passengers they need to travel. For example, during the night time, for example, less number of people will travel. Obviously, for night time, it is not the optimal to use the bus. Then design of the library operation system. For example, in our library, different operation with people borrow the book, lend the book. Then taxi, truck, railroad dispatching system. They apply the simulation. Production facility scheduling. Let's say, for example, for the production in the Almarai company, based on the demand, for their products, they can manage the resources. So we could do apply the simulation. Plant layout, capital investment. Capital investment, for example, capital investment, we can say for the businessman, before making any investment, he will check about the condition. If I will go for this, then what might be the outcome? Then production scheduling, sale forecast. Yes, in the case of a sale forecast, let's simple example is suppose what might be the sale of the product. Oh, then we can do the same as inventory planning and control. Simple example for the inventory control and planning is we can so take simple example for the Panda, in which what they do of people they are coming continuously make the purchase. Then our database is maintained, operation database is maintained. So the manager at the Panda, or in other words we can say manager the inventory control, he can make an advance order based on the sale of a product to the supplier. We can easily manage, we can easily control, we can easily control them with some metric. Or for example, as I just mentioned in the start of the lecture, that this simulation can also be used for the education, simulation can also be used for the learning, simulation can also be number variety of the purpose for there. Now let's talk about the advantages and disadvantages of simulation. Here we can the more appropriate word, the advantages and challenges. We can say for what are the challenges. This is not about disadvantage, because right now as our technological advancement is there, so previously what we found disadvantage, right now we overcome the problem. Let's see what are the description was there. Advantage, using the simulation technique, it is flexible because we just require to change the parameter, because we are doing experiment with the computer. changing some of the parameter, we can say that what are the behavior of the output, what are the output result. Moreover, maybe we can add, remove some of the parameters, some of the variable we will define, more variable or object we can define, or some of the object we can delete them. In the computer it is easy, yes. Moreover, it is straightforward. It is flexible and straightforward. Just change something, get the result. Another advantage, can analyze large, complex, real-world problem for which no closed-form analytical solution exists. As I mentioned, what is analytical solution? Or analytical solution means, analytical solution means it is something generalizable. We should work for all of the testing, for all of the condition. Sometimes, especially for the very complex problem, very complex system, very complex scenario, it is not possible if you want to. We cannot find easily the analytical solution. We find some infinite number of outputs. It is not in the closed form. Then we can go for the simulation. Then can include real world complication. The most other techniques cannot. So in the real world problem, for example, here we have a lot of complication were there. Then simulation provide a mechanism, at least with make some assumption, we can find how the system will work, how the system will behave, what will be the output of the system. Another, time compression. Time compression means less time will be required to design a system, because we required all of the working will be performed in the computer. So less time will be required, or time compression, and with the use of less time, we at least we know the how system output. Allow what if type. If then, so obviously, since we are doing the experiment with the computer, so it means we can apply the technique if then, as if these are the condition, what will be the output, else what are the, or in other words, simply we can say what if, or if then else, if then as, we can easily formulate, enable, allow what type of what if type question, or if then as, if they are the condition, then this will be the output, else another, then does not interfere with the real system. Real world system. We are doing the experiment with a computer. We want to retrieve the result. At least it is not required for us to know the behavior of the system without interfering the real world. Our operation will be performed with the computer. Allow study of the relationship. Every system consists of number of objects, number of parameters, number of attributes, number, etc. Every system consists of this one. Sometimes we are more interested about this system internals. That is, what are the relationship between different objects, different parameter, is there any relationship between them or not? We can easily find out with the simulation. Then what are the challenges do we have, or disadvantages do we have? Can be expensive and time consuming. It can be expensive means in order to go for the simulation, we required some model. We require this modeling required expertise, someone who know the programming, someone who know how to design a system, someone who will get the result, then he knows how to interpret these results. Sometimes we might require to purchase some of the software. This software, it is not free. Sometimes if you are the genius, then you can customize by yourself, especially for the complex problem. On the other hand, obviously some time will be required, some money will be required, because you need to go for simulation, first you will design the model and write the program. Does not yield optimal. One of the main challenge for the simulation is we will not get the optimal solution. We as I just mentioned in the previous slide, that it will give the good solution, not the best one. I give the example as, say I want to get the driving license. Just fulfill the requirement, get the driving license. It is not they will ask me that, okay, how more efficient I can drive the Ferrari or not. So we will not yield the optimal solution. We will only get the good solution. Required good management input. Obviously, when you design a system, go for the simulation. You must have the capability or the manager or manager skills should you must have. Manager skills were there. Resources you can allocate, or you can formulate design, or we formulate design or model the system, etc. Then results not generalizable to other. In as simple as we can say, what we get the result from the simulation, they are not generalizable. Maybe these results, they are good only for particular condition, particular environment, some initial condition, and they were good. Whereas, and these model can maybe work for only some particular environment, particular weather or particular climate, particular. So in other words, they are not generalizable. Sometimes they only work for the some specified condition, specified environment, etc. Okay, we will stop right now. Just need to discuss that inshallah on Wednesday we will have the midterm exam. I have already uploaded the guidelines in the LMS. You can two or 3 weeks ago I uploaded the guidelines. Moreover, the examination committee approved that our mid exam will be on Wednesday. Previously it was 11th of March. Right now it is the 10th of March at 5 o'clock, as you can see in the LMS. One more thing. Previously I give that the exam will be from the first four chapter. Later on I have removed chapter number one. Though then the scope of the exam only consists of chapter number two, number three, and chapter number four, three chapter. Moreover, in the matter exam there is no essay question, there is no multiple choice, there is no true and false. They are not included. I have already updated this information in the LMS for those of the student who, for example, right now six student they are absent today. For those student, they can see in the LMS. If anything else you need to ask me, that's okay. Otherwise, you may leave the session. Thank you.